Mother Nature. Our world is filled with endless beauty, but have you ever stopped and wondered how nature works together to make it all so beautiful? Flowers grow almost everywhere on Earth. And where there are flowers, there are bees. Move your head and take a look around. Have you ever wondered how we have so much floral diversity in our world? Those flowers that you see are supporting life for bees, and in turn, the bees support the life of the flowers through pollination. Now hold on, we're about to take flight and fly over to Virginia to visit the sweet Virginia honeybee farm just outside of Washington, D.C. There, we'll learn about how pollinators, like honeybees, make it all possible. That was a wild ride. Welcome to Virginia. My name is Sarah, and I'm going to be your guide for this super sweet field trip today. We are at the Sweet Virginia Honeybee Farm right outside of Washington, D.C., and today we're going to be exploring where bees live and work. Are you all excited to go check out some honeybees?
Yeah!
Okay, everyone. Here we are at the beehives. A hive is a bee home. Each hive houses one colony of honeybees. A colony is a family of bees that work together to raise and protect the next generation of bees. Honeybees are known as cavity nesters because they live in holes or chambers. They live in natural beehives like hollow trees, but humans have been making homes for them for thousands of years. Most beekeepers in the U.S. provide their bees with hive boxes for homes just like the ones you see here. As you can imagine, it's so much easier to check our bees and collect honey from these hive boxes than from inside of a tree. Before we open it, let's puff some smoke around the hive. Don't worry, this isn't harmful to the bees at all. The smoke just keeps the bees calm while we take a look inside their hive. Bees enter and exit out of the hive entrance, right here. See the bees coming and going? These are forager bees, one of the many jobs of a worker bee. In a single day, one forager bee makes 12 or more trips from the hive, visiting several thousand flowers. On these foraging trips, the bee can travel up to 5 miles away from the hive. The ones leaving are going to visit flowers. The bees coming back are full of nectar or carrying pollen. Bees have pollen-collecting hairs all over their body. And by traveling from plant to plant, they spread the pollen, which helps ensure our crops are healthy so we can eat yummy fruits, vegetables, nuts, and seeds. Fun fact, honeybees even pollinate cotton for the clothes we wear. So what's in it for the bees? Why do they visit flowers? If you said honey, you are correct. Okay, now let's get in there and take a peek at the colony and their honey. Right now, we are looking at around 60,000 bees. That is about as many people that can fit into a football stadium. You'll see bees crawling around everywhere. It looks a little confusing and sounds a little overwhelming. But while some things in nature seem a little messy and disorganized, they're actually very complex and well-organized. Fun fact, it takes visits to 2 million blossoms to make 1 pound of honey. Here you can see the arc of capped honey, which can stay edible for thousands of years. Bees store their honey at the top and around the sides of the brood, the word for honeybee babies. Look how beautiful this is. Next is the nectar, which is currently being made into honey by the worker bees. Then we have stored pollen that is being made into bee bread, which is a mix of honey and pollen to feed the young. This brings us to one of the most exciting parts of the hive, the nursery. Here, eggs hatch in cells, which become larvae, then pupae, and eventually emerge as adult bees. Oh, check it out. A new worker bee is emerging from her cell right now. Let's look a little closer to see the bees and their first stages of life. Here are the eggs. Here are the larvae. And under these poofy cappings are pupae, the last stage before emerging as a fully grown adult. Fun fact, did you know that most of the bees in the hive are female? The rest are male bees that are called drones. Ah, sweet. Here's who I've been looking for. Everybody take a close look at this bee. Does she look different from the others? Perhaps a little bigger than the other bees? Yep, that is the queen bee. Great job. This is the bee that laid all of the eggs we were just looking at. Farms aren't the only places where bees live. Many schools and universities also have hives. Who wants to go check out the research apiary at George Mason University?
Me!
Okay, hold on. Let's go fly like honeybees. Wow. Welcome to George Mason University. Here, students and researchers collaborate to educate the community about the importance of honeybees and what they can do to help keep them happy and healthy. They work here with local communities near Washington, D.C., and as far away as places like Colombia and Peru. So are you guys ready to go in and check out these hives?
Yes.
Awesome. Ooh, beautiful.
Whoa.
Oh, this frame's got it all.
Why can't we do it?
Okay, is the queen bee there?
The queen bee is not here.
Okay.
But what else do we see?
Honey.
We see honey, and we see nectar, capped honey.
Eggs, or like the babies.
Yep, there's definitely some eggs down in there. And then...
those babies.
Yep, the babies. And what is the word for babies in this stage?
Larva.
Exactly. And do you remember what the stage is when they're under the cappings, the poofy cappings? Poofy.
Larva, pupa?
Pupa, exactly.
I knew that.
Awesome, Isaac. Here is your last fun fact. Honeybees are the most recognizable type of bee around the world, but there are about 20,000 different bee species on this planet, including 4,000 bee species right here in North America. They all work together with other pollinators like hummingbirds and butterflies to pollinate our food and the majority of wildflowers you see, which will become seeds and fruits to feed all kinds of wildlife, from tiny songbirds to giant grizzly bears. Okay, kids, that wraps up our field trip today. Thank you for coming on this journey with us to the Sweet Virginia Honeybee Farm and George Mason University. You've had an up-close glimpse into their amazing world that not many people get to have. Hopefully, you're inspired with awe and wonder about the magic of nature and the honeybee. I sure am.